At last, we come to circuits, or at least some laws that apply to them. Let's start by introducing Gustav Kirchhoff. Kirchhoff was a physicist that made some rather large contributions to the fields of thermodynamics, like the term black body radiation, spectroscopy, and circuit theory in the mid-1800s. For our purposes, he's famous for setting things to zero. Let's start our discussion of Kirchhoff's laws with Kirchhoff's current law, or KCL, as electrical engineers lazily and affectionately refer to it. The law, simply stated, says the current entering something must equal the current leaving it. So, if I were to draw an arbitrary boundary with two currents entering it, say IN1 and IN2, then the currents leaving it, say IOUT1, IOUT2, and IOUT3, must equal the input currents, or mathematically, IN1 plus IN2 equals IOUT1 plus IOUT2 plus IOUT3. More formally stated, Kirchhoff's current law says the sum of currents entering any node or closed boundary must add up to zero. This law should make sense to us if we have a little bit of background in physics. The principle here would be that of the conservation of charge, that is, charge cannot be created or destroyed, at least under normal circumstances. This makes sense in light of the law of conservation of energy, but that's a discussion for another day. We usually apply this law to a node. That was defined in the last video, though there are occasions where we do extend it to a closed boundary. How this might look for a piece of circuit is this. Here we have 5 resistors connected at a single node. If we assume that the other ends of the resistors are connected somewhere to provide the currents, then using Kirchhoff's current law, all 5 currents must add to zero. In this case, it will require that at least one of the 5 currents is negative. But that's not really a big deal. All a negative current means is that it goes in the opposite direction the arrow's pointing. Let's apply this to a simple circuit. Here, we have an unknown current through a resistor. If we use the top node to apply KCL, I might define currents that enter the node as positive and those that leave the node as negative. So I can say that 3 amps minus 4 amps plus 7 amps minus Ix must equal zero. Then, solving, Ix must be equal to 6 amps. Kirchhoff also came up with another circuit law called Kirchhoff's voltage law, or KVL. This law states that the sum of voltages around any closed path must add to zero. A common way of stating this law is that the voltage rises around a closed loop must equal the voltage drops. This might look like this. If we take an arbitrary loop with arbitrary elements and indicate the voltages across each element, if we add them all up, we must get 0 volts. The question then remains, how do we define a voltage increase? That is a matter of choice. There are 2 possible ways to do this. One is to go around the loop and mark the voltage in each equation with the sign we first encounter. So if I start here, I encounter the positive sign on V1, so I would call that positive. Continuing on, V2 would be positive, V3 negative, V4 negative, and V5 negative. Another way to define the voltages is by the change in the voltage across each element. So if we go from a negative sign to a positive sign, that would indicate a voltage increase. But if we go from a positive sign to a negative sign, that is a voltage drop. Either method works as long as you are consistent. I'll choose the latter method because it reflects my perception of reality just a little bit more. Using the latter method, I will go around the circuit clockwise first. Starting at this point, V1 goes from a positive to a negative, so I will call that a voltage drop. V2 does also. V3 goes from a negative to a positive, so I will call that a voltage rise and put it on the other side of the equation. The same is true for V4 and V5. So we have the voltage drops, V1 and V2, must equal the voltage rises, V3, V4, and V5. If we go around the loop counterclockwise, we get a similar result. However, the voltage rises and drops switch. Starting at V3, we go from a positive to a negative, so that is a drop. V2 goes from a negative to a positive, it is a rise, as is V1. Continuing on, V5 and V4 are drops. The equation in the end is the same, so the results are equivalent. Let's apply this to an actual circuit. Given this circuit, if we go around the loop clockwise and apply KVL, here we go from a negative to a positive. That is an increase of 12 volts. Here we go from a positive to a negative. That is a decrease of 3 volts.
Again, here we go from a positive to a negative. That is a decrease of 2 volts. Here we go from a negative to a positive. That is an increase of 4 volts. And here we go from a negative to a positive for an increase of Vx. Now we have completed the loop, and by KVL this must be equal to 0. We can solve for Vx and get a negative 11 volts.
So there we have it, Kirchhoff's laws. Kirchhoff's current law says that the currents that enter and leave a closed boundary must sum to 0, while Kirchhoff's voltage law says that the sum of voltages around any closed path must add to 0. I also told you that out of laziness and affection, these laws are commonly referred to as KCL and KVL. Next time, we'll go over how Kirchhoff's laws, in combination with Ohm's law, can be used to solve for all the voltages and currents in any circuit. Until next time, go out and make it a great one.